Good morning everyone. So today we are going to learn about torque and moment arm. Right? To understand this, let's understand shoulder joint and elbow joint. So here is your scapula. And here is your coracoid process, right?
Yes, sir.
And now this is your humeral head. We have acromion process here, and then we have clavicle, right?
Yes, yes sir.
So this is your clavicle here. Let's make ulna and radius. So we have polycranon process here at the ulna, and then it will extend here, and then this will come here. And then radius. Right?
Yes, sir.
Then we have grip here. So let's catch a dumbbell of 40 lbs. This is dumbbell of
40 lbs.
To understand how much force we need to complete this joint of action, let's draw a muscle here. This bicep muscle coming from top. It origins from supraglenoid tubercle, right?
Yes, sir.
And the second bicep muscle origins from coracoid process and inserts at the radial tuberosity, at the radius bone. Right? So we have to understand how much force this muscle required to complete this joint of action with this weight, 40 lbs, right?
Yes,
so
sir.
We need some consideration such as weight. What is weight? 40 lbs. Then what we need? We need torque. So let's make torque at this joint. So torque is zero at this joint. Right?
Yes, sir.
And this zero is equal to three torques. Zero is equal to three torques. Let's see what are those. Zero is equal to three torques. So firstly, what we need in consideration? Weight. Second, we need to understand what is the length of this forearm. So from olecranon process, if we go till wrist joint, it is 10 inches. And till grip, this is 4 centimeter. Approximately in centimeter, this is 35 centimeter, right? So we have calculated the distance. So let's name this D1. So in consideration, we will put 35 centimeter. This is D1. Right?
Yes, sir.
Then we need to understand the center of the mass. So what is the center of the mass here? From this center of the mass till this joint, this is going to be 35 divided by 2 is 17.5 centimeter. So in consideration, what we require? Center of mass is how much? 17.5 centimeter. Right?
Yes,
so
sir.
Let's, this is also distant calculation. So let's put it D2. So we have D1, D2. We put into the circle. Right?
Yes, sir.
Then we need the weight of this forearm. So weight of forearm. Right?
Yes,
so
sir.
The weight of the forearm is approximately 3 lbs. How much?
3 lbs.
Then what else we require into the consideration is the insertion point of this bicep muscle from the elbow joint. So this distance is approximately 4 centimeters. So let's take, this is D3. This is also distance calculation. So we have D3, how much?
4 centimeters.
Let's put it into equation, right? Now 0 is equal to 3 torques. So what we have in consideration? 40 lbs. Then D1 is how much? 35 centimeter bracket hour, and this is going to be positive torque. Whenever this weight is moving clockwise, this is called positive torque. So D1 is moving down here, so this is going to be positive torque, right? Then what is next coming here? What is the forearm weight? It is 3 lbs, right?
Yes, sir.
So 3 lbs bracket hour. Then what is the distance? D2, we have mentioned it here. This is D2. This is
D2.
D2. This is also going as a clockwise, right?
Yes, sir.
So this, how much? D2 is equal to 17.5 centimeter bracket hour.
Yes, sir.
Then what's going to happen? We need to complete the joint of action. What we require?
We need to complete the joint of action.
That's going to be negative torque.
Negative torque.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So that's negative torque is what? This bicep need to pull it to complete this joint of action. This bicep has inserted at the 4 centimeter, right? So
yes,
that's going to be negative torque. So what force? D3, right? Now force D3 equal to 40 lbs bracket over D1, 35 centimeter plus we have 3 lbs, then we have D2 17.5 centimeter, right?
Yes,
so
sir.
We have taken this side here,
yes,
and we need to divide this by negative torque. So negative torque is what? D3, how much? 4 centimeter.
Yes.
So this centimeter will go off. And remaining will be the calculation, the force we require. So if we calculate this 40, give me calcium please. So 40 times 35 plus 3 times 17.5 divided by 4. So approximately, to complete this joint of action, we require 363 lbs force. 363 lbs force, right?
Yes, sir.
So I hope you have understood how this torque is calculated. Thank you very much.